Hello everyone, welcome back to your channel. If you're visiting to your channel for a first time, then this is my small introduction. I'm thankful for each and every member because it's just you and just you who is helping me and this channel to grow. I thoroughly enjoy learning and sharing software development languages and technologies with you. It's a mission which I'm trying to drive to share knowledge with everyone whose aim is to establish career in software. Please keep watching, sharing, and motivating others to subscribe to your channel. Also press the bell icon to never miss the updates. Thank you. Let's start learning. Today we are going to talk about three objects, special objects, task, event, and activities. Now, when I say these are the special objects, so that is because of the particular reason. They make a polymorphic relationship. So when I say the polymorphic relationship, so I mean, you have to first learn the relationships. The videos are already available in the playlist. I will put the link of the playlist in the description. If you haven't understood or you haven't, you know, the covered relationship topics, so you can cover from there. Let us see what is task, event, and object. Before I move to Salesforce, let me, you know, make you understand the difference between these two objects. Task means a work has been assigned to you and that can be completed anytime within that time frame. Let's say there's a deadline of you know, to complete it, any job, any task by 30 April. So from today, before 30, you can complete the task at any time. Event means that a job need to be completed in a specific time. Let's say, if I say that, you know, this particular job need to complete at 12 April at 9 p.m. or in between 12 April, 9 p.m. till 13 April, 8 a.m. You can complete. So this is the difference we have. Now let us understand more about task, event, and activities. And this is very important. Not many times, you know, even in the interview, people ask the questions. I'm in Salesforce here. And let me, you know, the open any, you know, the object, let's say account. And let's say I open one record. You will see here, in this side, new task, new event. When you click on a new task, you can give, you know, the subject, okay, due date. I'm sorry, this is not, you know, the must, but if you want to give, then you can give. And then you saved. Okay. Event, that the start date is must and end date is must. Okay. And you can give the any subject. And you say. So that's why, you know, the only difference we have in between the task and event is of time. You don't have any particular time on which you have to complete the task. Whereas in event, we have a particular time frame in which we have to complete. Now, these are the two objects we have, and let me show you. Task. Event. Okay. And now I'm talking about the activity. Okay. So what is the, I mean, we understood the meaning of the, you know, the importance of the task object. We understood the importance of the event object. Now, what does this activity do? Is this a simple heading here? Or is there any specific role we have of activity? Yes, we do have the role of the activity object. What is the main role? I clicked on task object, field and relationship. Now here I don't have any option to create custom field. Same, let me duplicate. You don't have. Let me duplicate. Now here I have the option. So what is, you know, the importance of the activity object is whenever you want to create any custom field, either on task object or, you know, the on event object or on both of them, you have to create the field, custom field on activity object. And once you will create the, you know, the field on activity object, you will get an option to show on either of the page layout or on both of the page layout, that is a task or event. Let me show you how. New. And let's say I'm clicking text. First, I'm trying to show you on task object. Same thing. I mean, no difference we have to while creating the field for a task. I mean, on activity object. Everything is same. Now here you have the option. You have to check the layout. If you want to make it available only on task object, make it, I mean, check this checkbox. If you want to make it available on both of the, you know, the objects, I mean, task and event, then check this checkbox. But let me show you one by one. April 12 task. So and object ID is 00T. You can see here, object 12 task. Correct? If I you won't be able to see this here. Now, as you can see that, you know, the, as I said, that the, this is the same option we have. I mean, the same way may, like we have created the custom field, so many custom field on different objects. You can change the field type as well, but always remember when you change the, you know, the field type, there's a probability of data loss. Okay. So same way, you can, you know, the create the the field and using the activity object, and you can use it either on a task object or event object or on both of them. One more thing, schema builder. This schema builder is almost, I mean, is a functionality to see the complete architecture of your org. So if I, you know, select, I mean, uncheck this activity object, it will disappear. And see here, two custom fields which I have created, you can see here. Okay. Hope this is clear. In the next video, next topic, I will be covering. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing, and don't forget to put a thumbs up. Thanks for watching the video.